at Tiffany's and bottles of bubbles. Girls with tattoos who like getting in trouble. Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things. Been through some bad shit, I should be a savage. Hi beauties, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I got this makeup look. I think I'm going to call this one like a purple sultry look, maybe. I think it's really cute. You have like a nice little half cut crease going on in here. And I'm just going to let you guys know that in the video, my brows are already filled in. And that's only because I already filmed a brow tutorial because my brows take forever. So I wanted to have them done for this video. But that video should already be up, so I will link it down below. That way you can watch that video if you want to see how I fill in my eyebrows. But yeah, I'm going to stop chatting. Okay, and we're going to get into this makeup look. So just keep on watching. Alright, so to start off this look, we're going to go into the Morphe X Jaclyn Hill palette. This is actually part of the Vault collection. This is the palette that's called Ring the Alarm. So we're going to go into that Rush shade. And this is going to be our, basically you can say like our transition shade. So this is going to help blend everything else out. But this shade, you don't have to be too like specific where you put it. We just want to kind of blow it out into the crease. So I'm taking it on a nice fluffy brush and I'm just going to apply it until I get the intensity that I want. Next, I'm going in with another palette from that collection. This is actually the Bling Boss palette, and I'm going in with the shade Rockstar. And I'm taking this on a smaller detailed brush because we don't want this color to go too high up. We kind of want it to stay in the crease. So I'm going to go ahead and build that up. This is actually a really pretty color. It's like a, it's not purple, it's like a plum color, if you will. And I think it's absolutely stunning, to be honest. It looks really nice on brown eyes. As you can see as well, I'm like taking this color all the way into the inner corner and to the outer corner because we're gonna go ahead and cut the crease. So now I'm taking that same fluffy brush. I didn't put any more color on it whatsoever, normal eyeshadow. It's just completely like whatever's left over. And I went ahead and I just buffed out the eyeshadow. We want to make sure we don't have any harsh lines, so that's what I'm doing here. Then I'm going to go back in with that detail brush and I'm going to intensify the color because the more you blend, it kind of fades away as you go. So you want to go back and forth between blending and building the color. Next, I'm taking another fluffy brush. This one's not as fluffy as the first one we was using, but it's fluffy enough to where it's going to blend out that purple shade without taking it too high up. So that's what I'm doing here. Next, we're going to go ahead and take a flat brush and we're going to cut the crease. So I'm just using my Tarte Shape Tape concealer. You can use any concealer of your choice. And I'm going to go ahead and cut the crease so that way we can have a nice clean canvas for the shades that we're going to put on the lid. So once we're done cutting the crease, we're going to go back into that Bling Boss palette, and right here I'm using a flat shader brush and I'm using the shade Glitz and Glam. So I'm putting this right on the inner corner and I'm packing it on. This is like a really nice, it has a purple undertone, but it's a nice almost champagne color, if you will. So I'm going to pack that onto the inner corner, and then on the outer half, so I'm only going towards like half of the eyelid, if that makes sense. And then towards the end, which you're seeing here, I'm going in with the shade Pizzazz. So it's more of like a purple glitter. Then I'm going to go back in with that little detail crease brush and we're just going to blend the Pizzazz shade and the Rockstar shade together. We want to make sure we don't have any harsh lines. And then again, we're going to go ahead and add some more pigment. Now I'm going in with this is actually the Benefit, the new Benefit Roller Liner. This stuff is amazing. It's super pigmented and very easy to use. So I just use that to line my lash line so that when we put on our lashes, you can't see where they start and like where your lashes start. You kind of want them to blend nicely. Then I'm going to coat my lashes with some mascara and we're going to pop on those falsies, girl, because ain't no look without some falsies. The falsies that I'm actually applying are Kiss Lashes. It's part of their Iconic collection, and it's in the number 1, I believe, 01. That's what these are called. They're absolutely stunning. I love these lashes. So I went ahead and did the other eye off camera, and now we're gonna move into foundation. So here's me realizing that in the viewfinder, my foundation looked like 20 shades lighter than my skin, but I swear to you guys, it was the right shade. It just looks really light on camera, but that's okay, girl, because once I start to put my bronzer, you can't even tell. So I applied the Hourglass Vanish Stick foundation, and now I'm just gonna blend it out with my beauty blender. This foundation is so bomb. I had actually bought it before and I returned it because it wasn't working for me so well. And then like everyone raves about it. So I was like, I need to try it again. And girl, let me tell you, the coverage on this is unreal. Now I'm going in with concealer. I'm actually using the new Fenty concealer, which is amazing. And this is in the shade, I believe I got the shade 170. Looking ghostly right now, but that's okay because bronzer is about to fix everything. So now I'm just setting with my powder. I'm actually using the Sephora Micro Smooth Powder, and I'm so sad that they discontinued this powder. So I will try to put like a dupe down below in the description box right next to where I put the name of this powder, since they actually don't have it anymore. So we're just setting everything in place, making sure nothing moves. Now we're going in with bronzer, thank God, because I look ghostly. So I'm actually using the IT Cosmetic Bye Bye Bronzer because, of course, this is my favorite bronzer. It's like very neutral. It's not too warm, but it's not too cool. It gives you just like the nice warmth to your face. It's very, very pretty. And it doesn't make you look orange, which is nice. So I'm just applying that to the cheekbones. I'm going to put that on the forehead, on the nose a little. Next, I'm going in with my blush. This is one of my favorites. This is Milani's Luminoso, I believe. And then I'm going in with highlights. So for highlighter, I'm actually using the Anastasia Beverly Hills and Amrezy highlighter. And on top of that, I'm using the Artist Couture powder in the shade Illuminati. Because, girl, we are glowing for the gods, okay? So I went ahead and zoomed you guys back in so that we could finish up these eyes. So for my waterline, I'm actually taking a black liner. This is the Tarte Cosmetics Tartiste liner. It's one of my favorites, and I'm taking the pencil side. This actually is a duo. It comes with a liquid on one side and a pencil on the other. I like both sides, but I've been really loving the Benefit one. That's why I didn't use this one. So I'm going to take a small brush and we're going to go back in with that Rush shade. Basically everything we did on the top of the lid, we're going to do on the lower lash line. So first I'm going in with the shade Rush and I'm just blowing that out in the lower lash line. And then I'm going to go in with that shade Rockstar to deepen it up. then I'm taking a more flat brush and I'm taking a black eyeshadow just to intensify the lower lash line a little bit. So I'm taking something that can get really close to the lash line. That's why this brush is like nice and flat. And I went ahead and pressed that in. And now I'm taking a fluffy brush and just blending everything out again. Next, I'm taking a pencil brush and I'm actually going into the shade Bling Bling from the Bling Boss palette. And I'm going to use that as my inner corner highlight. I feel like this really tied the whole look together, that bright inner corner. I think it looks absolutely stunning. Now for our lips, I'm going in with the Morphe lip liner in the shade Sweet Tea. And can we just talk about how cheap these lip liners are? They're like $3 for a lip liner and the pencil is huge. Then for our lipstick, this has quickly become one of my favorites. This is actually a collaboration with Makeup Shayla here on YouTube and ColourPop Cosmetics. And this is the lipstick in the shade Quickie. It's a beautiful nude. It's not too bright, but it's not too dark. It's like perfect. So I figured it'd go nice with this look since it's a warm nude. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and set all this powder, all this makeup down with the MAC setting spray. And that is it for this look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this makeup look. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And stick around because your girl is posting a lot more often. Please let me know all your comments down below and I will see you in my next video. Bye!